Until today I was homeschooled. I know what you're thinking, homeschooled kids are freaks, but that couldn't be further from the truth. Until today, I've lived a pretty normal life. Little did I know that would all change once I started Franklin High School.
Hey, I'm Janice, you're new here, right?
Yeah, I'm Katie.
Welcome to Franklin High, Katie. I'm Damien.
Thanks, being here is really nerve-wracking.
Who are they?
Those are the Plastics.
The Plastics?
If Franklin was Us Weekly, they'd always be on the cover.
They're like teen royalty. Misdemeanor on the floor, pretty boy, here I come. Pumps in the bump, make you wanna hurt something. I can take your man, I don't have to set some. Hang him out the window, call me Michael Jackson. I'm a pain in your rectum. I am that bitch y'all slept on. Heavy hit around, spitter, call me rerun. Hey, 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 I'm what's happening. Hypnotic in my drink, that's right. Shake till it sink, that's right. Mr. Moe's on the beat, that's right. Put it down. How would you even begin to describe Regina George?
I've heard her hair is insured for $10,000.
I saw Regina wearing army pants and flip-flops, so I bought army pants and flip-flops.
One time, she punched me in the face. It was awesome.
I hear she does car commercials in Japan.
One time, she saw John Stamos on a plane, and he said she was pretty.
I heard she has 2 penny purses and a silver Lexus.
Regina is the queen bee of Franklin High School. She knows everything about everybody. She's quite the gossiper.
The other two are just her little minions. They do everything and anything that she asks of them. It's kind of sad, really. But I guess it's the rational choice.
Rational choice?
It's the idea that people who deviate weigh their choices and choose the best option for them. And the best option at surviving high school is being her friend.
We learned in sociology last year that there's 3 ways to describe her deviance that Regina and the Plastics display every day. The first being biological, which basically says that Regina was born evil, or should we say predisposed to deviance.
The second being the psychological explanation, which implies that Regina's deviancy occurred early on in life as a result of abnormal or inadequate socialization by her parents.
The last possibility, sociological, says that you should look outside Regina to see why she's deviant and what causes her behavior.
I like to believe that Regina was born evil, to be honest.
Hey, I'm Regina, and this is Karen.
Hey. Hi, I'm Katie.
Oh, we know. We've heard a lot about you. Let's talk. So you were homeschooled?
Yeah.
That's, like, really interesting. So you've never been to an actual real school before?
No, this is my first day.
But you're, like, really pretty.
Thanks.
So you agree? You think you're really pretty?
I don't know.
Wait, what were you doing talking to Janice Ian? She's like a total wannabe freak loser.
She seems really nice.
Oh my god, you're so lucky we saved you from her. Like, being friends with her is a total social suicide. Trust me, you're like totally.
Totally what?
What?
God, Karen, you're so stupid!
You know what I'm thinking?
Yeah.
Makeover!
Whoa, is this your bedroom?
Yeah, it was my parents', but I made them trade me.
It's so big and beautiful.
Oh, that's our burn book.
Burn book?
It's where we take pictures of all the girls in our grade and write really mean things about them.
If anyone ever found that, we'd be in major trouble. Whatever. Are you ready for your makeover?
It's ready as all over me.
Sometimes I forget my middle name.
Normally I wouldn't condone deviance, but Regina had to be stopped. It was her type of deviance that reduced the certainty that others will obey the norms of society, others' willingness to play by the rules, and who knows how much money we spent in counseling as a result of Regina George. All I knew was that everyone should see what a gossiping, bullying deviant she really is.
Here I come, pumps in the bump, make you wanna hurt something. I can take it, man, I don't have to say something.
what I have. They have this burn book where they write all this mean stuff about everyone in the grade.
What do you plan to do with that?
Publish it.
Destroy that deviant devil that's Regina George. Excellent.
I know it may seem like I was becoming deviant, but that's because I was becoming deviant. I was definitely internalizing what I was about to do. My friends didn't think I was, so I wasn't informally labeled by informal controls, and neither were the police, which would be formal labeling by formal controls. But I knew that what I was doing was wrong. But being with the plastic was like being with teen royalty, and it was worth it for what I had planned.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
What I wasn't expecting was this.
Never in all my years of teaching have I seen this level of deviance in high school. Now, I have four different theories as to why two perfectly good students could have fallen so far so fast. Now, I'm guessing that the two of you are not deviant because of your social class. That rules out the lower class focal value theory, in which your social standing may affect your deviance. And I also don't believe that the control theory could be applied to either of you, seeing as I honestly don't believe that you were born deviant, and it's clear that you cannot control it if you were. That leaves the strain theory and one other. The strain theory says a person tries for material success but doesn't achieve it unless they use deviance. So, that doesn't apply here either. What could it possibly be?
I don't see principle written on me.
The only one left is a differential association theory, so clearly that's it.
What are you saying about?
The theory suggests that deviance is inherited, not learned by your surroundings. Like, we're affected by who we hang out with.
Now, the two of you realize that you have to be punished for your actions.
Well, actually, I think this entire incident could be used to help people.
And how is that so, Miss George?
Well, in sociology, we learned that there are four different functions of deviance. For one, it sets boundaries. The girls in the school won't want to gossip after they hear about everything that's happened, all the pain it's caused.
The warning function is also present here. This incident warned us that our school's gossip policy is new changing. And it also functions to create solidarity amongst the girls in our grade. Even though gossip and bullying is what brought us closer together, we are more unified as a result.
I'm not quite sure that's a good thing, but...
But then there's the innovation function, which inspires change. Change that the school really needs to become a safer and better place.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
One time she punched him in the face and it was awesome.
Being psychological explanation, which implies that baby Regina Stevensy is early.
Regina is the queen bee of Franklin High School. She knows everything about everyone. That's why her head is so big. Knows everything about everybody. She stepped over a lot of people to get where she is. Maybe that's why her feet are so big.
Hey, I'm Janice. You're new here, right?
Yeah, I'm Katie.
I'm sorry.